Now, with Labour, the Conservatives and UKIP in the Assembly having leadership elections, Plaid Cymru decided at the very last minute that it fancied joining in the fun. We've already heard from Leanne Wood and Rhian Ap Iorwerth, so today it's Adam Price's turn to set out his stall. Borda, good morning. You said just a few months ago, this movement doesn't need a thousand would-be leaders, we have one backer. What changed?
Well, I think the whole of Welsh politics is changing, isn't it? I think we're going through a great reset moment, you know, and this is an opportunity, I think, for us, because, you know, when I look at Welsh politics at the moment, it's an oasis of stasis in a world of change, you know. We need, as a small country, we need big ideas, we need new ideas, we need to inject into our political discourse a sense that politics can be transformative. That was the great prize of devolution. We've started to lose our sense of belief that actually we can change Wales. And I think it's great that we're having this leadership campaign because we can instill an energy, a confidence, a self-belief back into our nation and into our people that democracy can make a difference.
In your article stating your interest in going for the leadership, you talked about the idea of co-leadership. And you also said that our comfort zone has been a strange mixture of philosophical abstraction and the predictable plodding politics of the parsimonious press release, the tired tweet and the formulaic Facebook status. Is it a good idea to think about co-leadership in the first place and attack your own party's staff as an opening pitch to be leader?
Well, no, that wasn't, that was making the point, actually, that we all of us have to raise our game. And that's true of me as much as anyone else, you know.
Co-leadership went down like a lead balloon, didn't it?
When you want to move a mountain, like, everyone has to grab a shovel. You know, we need 10,000 shovels, actually. If we're going to get there, then we, all of us, have to actually raise our game in our ability to actually inspire people with an idea, a vision of a different Wales, you know?
It's become personal already, though, hasn't it? Your constituency colleague, Jonathan Edwards, laying into Leanne Wood on Friday about showing no leadership on Brexit, he says, and she's responded by saying, let's not have a scorched earth policy.
Yeah, I think there's a tendency in modern politics, isn't there, is to look at the melodrama, you know, of personality, and I think we should steer clear of that, right? We should be about putting forward our positive vision, right? And how we persuade people, you know, because ultimately, as politicians, we are in the persuasion business. We are persuading people that it doesn't have to be this way, that we can create a future that is better than the past. That's why I got involved in politics, you know, all those years ago. And for me, Plaid is a vehicle for that better vision. So let's actually focus there about how we can actually re-inject into Welsh politics the kind of excitement and enthusiasm and hope that we saw at the beginning of devolution back in 1999.
You opened your pitch with an idea, co-leadership. It went down like a lead balloon. And it gave the impression that you didn't really want to go for leadership.
I'm not going to apologise for being a creative thinker, right? What I was trying to do there was to say, well, look, we need a change in direction as a party, because if we continue just on the path that we're on, we will miss the huge historic opportunity that will be there for us in 2021 to change the future course of our country. But there are many, many aspects of things that have been achieved under Leanne's leadership that we should build on and maintain. Can we do both? Why does politics always have to be a zero-sum game? You know,
she can crack on and we're doing what she's doing then, isn't she?
Well, I think we have to change some things, right? I think that if you want to paint a vision of the future that people can believe in, you have to do two things. You have to paint in vivid brushstrokes, right? Create a very compelling vision, and you have to do the fine detail as well. That's the kind of programme of ideas that I think that the Welsh people are crying out for. If you know, in Wales we're needing...
Let's talk about programme ideas, because going into the last Assembly election, you wrote the Plaid Cymru manifesto, and you said it was the most innovative, ambitious, forward-looking programme ever offered to the people of Wales. You also made the criticism about Labour being in government for eons since the start of devolution. You've made those arguments, you've offered an agenda, and it hasn't been accepted by the Welsh people.
Well, we made some progress, but it wasn't at the scale and the pace that was necessary.
So what changes in 2021? Another manifesto, 400 pages this long this time, and the same argument that Labour's been in power for too long. You know, other than changing the leader, what changes?
You need two things, I think, to create a pivot moment in politics. You need two things. You need a body of ideas that inspire people and are credible as well. I'm sure that we can do that. And then you need to be able to articulate those. You know, in a sense, what is leadership, right? It is taking people on a journey, right? It is actually creating a narrative that people can understand. Where do we come from? Why are we at this point? What is holding us back? And what can we do about it? And that's, I think, the key question is who is best able to articulate that journey that I believe the Welsh people want to come with us on.
Let's talk about an idea you're positing today. A penny on income tax to fund education over the 5 years of the next Assembly term. Is that going to make as much of a difference as you hope? And you talked just a year or so ago about a penny on income tax to pay for education and the NHS. I mean, you're not quite sure which one you want to go for.
I think a key question you've got to ask yourself, right, is what is our foremost ambition, right? We're not going to be world leading at everything, right? Overnight, certainly. So we have to concentrate on those areas that are mission critical to the Wales that we want to create. And over 20 years, we have underinvested in the skills of our own people, in the knowledge of our own people. So our schools, our colleges and universities are underfunded compared to England, indeed our competitors across the world. And then we ask ourselves why our economy has stagnated. We have to reverse that. We have to become the knowledge nation of the 21st century. And that requires investment. It requires innovation too. Just putting more money in is not enough. But we can actually do what Ireland did. Ireland, an economy that was actually the lower ranks in the late 70s, actually saw the opportunity to invest in its education system.
And so that no actually, extra money for the NHS under your watch?
Well, no. I think that I'll have more to
another
say.
Another penny on income tax for that as well?
Look, I'll have more to say. Some of the critical issues that haven't been solved in this Labour government, affordable housing, health and social care integration. We've been talking about 20 years about doing it. Why don't we get on and do it? But unless we actually do something about our failure to invest in the skills and talent of our own people, where are the new doctors going to come from? Where are the nurses going to come from? How are we going to actually achieve the prosperous economy which is going to fund the kind of decent public services, including in health, that we want to see?
One of the biggest criticisms from those who support independence through the Yes Cymru movement is that Plaid Cymru isn't doing enough, isn't pushing independence as the main option front and centre. Would it be front and centre of a Plaid Cymru leadership under your
It has
leadership?
To be. I mean, I have been consistent about this throughout my political life, and I was one of the ones arguing in 2003 when we actually made it for the first time, incredibly, our explicit policy, right? The question is, what is our plan for independence? People of Wales are moving, right? There are people that are indie curious. There are some that are indie cautious, but are interested in having a debate. Some people who feel, in my heart, I want to see it in my lifetime, but I want to see the plan. I will produce that plan.
Just shortly, is the plan still to have an independence referendum at the second term of your leadership?
Yeah, I think that we need a 10-year plan. We need to actually address the economic failure. We need to transform our public services because that will instill in the Welsh people a belief that we can do things for ourselves.
Adam Price, thank you very much. Diolch yn fawr.